everybody, welcome back to TAZS's Wig Closet at WIG Studio 1. I never get tired of looking at the style and wearing this style. It is arguably the one that started the whole beach wave trend to begin with many years ago. This is Julianne by Jon Renau. I have it here in the color Palm Springs Blonde. It's also in a petite size. I'm going to apply this wig right out of the box and wake it up right before your eyes. Coming up. This style was provided to me by WIG Studio 1 for this wig review today so that I can try it and explain it before you make the investment. You can find it at WIG Studio 1. If you expand the description box below, I'll put a link directly to this style where you can check out the details and the pricing. If you have any questions for us, please reach out to support@wigstudio1.com. And they've also introduced a live chat feature. So from any product page on the website, you can scroll down, hit the help button to have an option to be connected with a live chat. Julianne, we must not forget about this beautiful beach wave style among all of the other beach wave styles, the wave of beach wave styles that has come upon the market in recent years. This is probably the one that started my love for the beach wave. It was chaotic and it was fun and it wasn't too serious. And it came with a hand tied cap and I just thought I was in heaven. So let's bring Julianne right out of the box so that I can show you what I do to wake up this style. And I actually pre-filmed this clip because I wanted to do some outdoor shots and I didn't want to do that with a wig that came right out of the box. Everybody knows that when a wig comes right out of the box, it's kind of tightly compacted to the head. And it really doesn't say a whole lot about what the potential of that style is. So that's why I like to get in there and really wake it up to flesh out the real style prior to my reviews. But many of you requested, and I will try to do this occasionally, but just apply it in front of your eyes and take you through a few things that I do to get ready for a review or get ready to wear this outside or in public. So let's take a look. I'll go ahead and put up the clip here. So this takes you from the time that I pulled it out of the box. The first thing I do is inspect the wig really well. It doesn't happen very often, if rarely at all, but sometimes you can get a defect in a wig and we have to send it back. So I don't want to review something that has a known defect in it. So I inspect it really well. And then I apply it and make my adjustments because the last thing I want is for this wig to start rolling around on my head while I'm doing a review. That's no good either. So once I have done those couple of things, what you will do is I just shake it out really, really well. You'll see me give this some really nice vigorous shakes. Now I'm not using a whipping round motion. So the next thing that I do is I turn the wig upside down or leave it upside down after shaking it. And I'll take a wide tooth comb and I will get down in the root and I will pull out from the cap. I will just go about 1 or 2 inches away from the cap and start again. And that's just, again, just to further unnest those fibers that have been so tightly compacted to that new wig. So a lot of times, even if it's a hand-tied style, there are a lot of machine-made elements to the style. And so when it's laid in the box to be ready to be shipped to you, it's asleep. We have to wake it up. And then another thing that I do is I'll just put my fingers in. I'll apply the wig and I'll put my fingers into the scalp and I'll just swirl. I will swirl and pull all over that wig cap. So what you see with Julianne, because her fibers are so fine and delicate, at least on the piece that I have here, is that you'll probably stir up a lot of flyaways on it when you are going through this process. And then I unravel the part and I kind of find a parting space that I'm happy with. And if it has been too stirred up, if there's a ton of flyaways or frizzies going on, I'll simply take some water and squirt it to kind of tame those back down. It works wonderfully. But now I'm ready. I'm ready to either go out in this wig style or I am ready to present it in a review. So that's it. That's all I did to this Julianne. This was actually filmed on a different day, but all I did was I removed it, I squirted a little water on it to kind of bring those flyaways back into line, and set it on a mannequin head until I had time to review it, which is today. So this Julianne Petite in the color Palm Springs Blonde. I have described Palm Springs Blonde quite a bit because this is my favorite blonde in the Jon Renau line, a part of the California Blondes collection. It's ash on ash on ash. You're looking at a light to medium ash blonde. You've got a white highlight that has been toned with more of a like a violet overtone to it. Now, sometimes you can kind of get a glimpse of that bluish violet tint to the white highlights here, but most of the time, and on many of the wigs that I have, I could not tell that there was any violet in it. It certainly doesn't read purple. It's just an overtone on the white. And then you have a dark blonde root, ash blonde root. Okay, the specs really quickly, about a 10.5 inch front piece on Julianne. So I'm about 6.5 from hairline at the bottom of my widow's peak to the bottom of my chin is about 6.5 inches. So with this 10.5 inch front, that's gonna stretch well below my chin, about 4 inches below my chin. So you'll have to look at your own measurements to determine how this front piece is going to strike you around the face. Overall, it's about 12 inches in the back. There's a slight graduation from the back to the front into those a little bit longer pieces. It actually is very minimally layered. And it's very lightweight. I think it only weighs like 3.5 ounces without looking. It feels very light and airy on the head as well. Now, this one does feature a full lace front, the Smart Lace Front Collection by Jon Renau, a full single hand-tied monofilament top and a hand-tied base all the way around. Let's get up close. This is done very, very well, this lace front is. So this lace front does run temple to temple. And all of the seams and everything seem to be very well obscured. The material that they use for the lace has a finer grid, but yet it's very strong. It lays flat to the head and it does have a nice transparent look to it. And then the top, you'll see that there is a full single monofilament top. That's going to give you the appearance of scalp no matter how you want to part it. And we will get into this cap in the cap segment. I'll give you a little more detail on this full cap. Talking about the beach wave curl on Julianne, Julianne is one of those styles you can expect quite a bit of variance from one piece to the next. The curl pattern in particular is especially vulnerable to some of these variances. One curl goes this way, the other one goes this way. This one has a really pretty curl pattern to it. I may continue to work on my parting space just to keep it out of my eyes and help it frame the face in the best way possible. But yeah, it's really nice. They've got a nice separated look to these waves. Some Juliennes that I have seen have a rounder, softer curl to them. This one, it seems to be a little more choppy and separated. It's just a nice broken, deconstructed spiral all the way around. One way that Julianne is a little more manageable than some other curly styles out there is that the curl really doesn't start until you get about 3 or 4 inches out from the scalp. Which is nice because when you have curl that goes almost all up to the scalp, it's a little more ornery, a little harder to work with and create your part. Now, this particular Julianne has no permatease in it, no palpable permatease. So you're not finding those extra little springy hairs sewn in at the base of the cap. Now, what they can do sometimes on a hand-tied style is they can scallop or rough up the root of each of the fibers. And that just gives it a little extra oomph, a little extra volume without adding any additional fiber. The actual density on this style is medium to light, actually. I've had some Juliannes that were full of hair and they were big and they were poofy. There was little you could do with it. Julianne comes in an average size and a petite size. I actually have the petite size. None of the other measurements are affected. It's the same exact style, just a little bit of a smaller cap. What I'm noticing is that it's probably about an inch shorter from ear to ear, front to back, and circumference. However, I still had to cinch in the adjusters to accommodate a 21¼-inch circumference. So a lot of times you have to crisscross the adjusters in a case like this if it was an average size. But because it is more of the petite, I don't have to cinch it in quite as far. There's no baggy cap anywhere. It fits me like a glove. It fits so well that I just jump for joy when I get a nice fitting cap like this. Here's an inside look at the cap for Jon Renau Julianne in the petite version, temple to temple, lace front. It does not extend back into the ear tab. There's a seam that adjoins the lace front to the single monofilament top. Beautifully hand-tied features. And then you have a full hand-tied mesh base. So this mesh base is very stretchy, light, and comfortable. And then getting up close here, you can see an idea of those cluster knots that are sewn into the cap. Same thing in the back. And then you have an extended felted nape with Velcro style adjusters. You'll notice that I pulled those adjusters in just a little bit to accommodate a true petite style circumference, but it fits beautifully from ear to ear and front to back. So Julianne plays very well with your glasses. They fit neatly and nicely between the ear and the ear tab, very comfortable and secure. So if you're a full-time glasses wearer, rejoice that Julianne is a great pick. There's no heavy densities or permatease in that area. So you can wear your sunglasses if you're full-time glasses wearer or readers like I have. You are going to have so many options to style Julianne. First of all, the length isn't too short. You can get a wee little pony out of it. You can change up the part, tuck it behind the ear. You can pull it away from the face. You can wear it in updos because of this beautiful hand-tied cap. You're not gonna have any problem with the realism. So let's go ahead and I'll take you through a few styling maneuvers here just so you can get a sense of what it's like to style. I hope you all have a wonderful day. We'll see you next time on TAZS's Wig Closet at Wig Studio One. So I think you all know that one of my favorite accessories for wigs is square bands, a hinged hairband, very gentle on wigs, and it props them up and holds them in place so nicely. It's just a must have if you are a wig wearer. And I am a rep with the square bands company. So if you do purchase from them, I'll leave all the links below. You can use the code TAZS. And that will give you 25% off of your order at this time.